Sir, hardly requires any introduction to this august audience. The stage is yours, sir.
Thank you, Sujal. At least I got chance. So since morning, the presentation was loaded. It is a carbidopsin new paradigm for PPH management. This is my CV slides, and I already invite all the persons to become a ORCID member. It is 87 ORCID publications are there, and recently I got PNB recognized, 2 CT in my place, and FMB recognized. Since morning we are talking about saving the mother. Rajeshji has beautifully said, how beautifully is arranged by Almighty, that when she delivers, mother is ready to take care. Father may not be there, mother is always there. With the blessings of mother of mine, 3 books written by me is recommended in our COG. 2 books gone for second edition, that is a class of fetal echocardiography, and I will made easy. And I'm editor-in-chief of 2 journals. Those who want to do work, they can contact me. So what we mean by consequence of PPH? Because this is PPH conclave. There is heavy blood loss, consequence of anemia. Okay, there is a heavy blood loss, consequent anemia, prolonged hospital stay, sir has rightly mentioned. She may go for divorce or postpartum psychosis, and sometimes maternal death or severe illness. We must remember that timely and right management, as Dr. Gupta and Dr. Manoj were discussing, fifth is time. So timely management will save mother from going for PPH. There is no single consensus. Somebody says primary, secondary, late PPH, but ultimately, tolerance to loss of blood vary in women with blood loss is often assessed by a visual assessment. But FIGO, SCOG and SOGS have stated that defined PPH as blood loss with potentially to produce hemodynamic instability. We all know the journey of labor. It is a series of events that occurs in woman's womb to deliver viable product of conception from uterus through cervix into the vagina in exterior with minimal aid. That is the first stage and second stage. What about this third stage when we are delivering the placenta? During third stage of labor, the separation of placenta from uterine myometrium is critical step in expulsion of the placenta. Bleeding is controlled by contraction and retraction of the uterine smooth muscles surrounding maternal arterioles. Contraction by smooth muscle is sufficient to compress the arterial wall and completely eliminating the arterial lumina and stopping blood flow that we all are known as natural ligature. But what happens when there is a uterine atrophy? It is failure of uterine smooth muscle fiber to contract and retract, and that is the major cause of PPH. This is natural ligature are there, and we have to thank Almighty, that is GOD, always in capital, generator, observer and destroyer, that they had given us beautiful thing that we can have this natural ligature, and God has given us enough amount of endogenous oxytocin. So what does oxytocin work on? Myometrial cell. The interaction of endogenous and administered oxytocin with myometrial cell receptor promotes the influx of calcium into the extracellular fluid from the sarcoplasmic reticulum into the cell, and this increase in cytoplasm calcium and stimulates the uterine contraction. But if you see, this doesn't happen in most of the parts of the world, and particularly in India, there is lots of maternal mortality because of postpartum hemorrhage. These are very old statistics, but still it's true. There is one death in every 8 minutes because of the hemorrhage. And today, in PPH enclave, we are here to save all this motherhood. We have to take at least, the management just now telling, one woman dies, there is 400 maternal morbidities are there. Because if you are scared of treating one PPH, you are not taking the cases of PPH, then that is lost to the society. All 40s, tissue trauma, thrombin, most common is uterine atony. What is uterine atony? It defines as failure of uterus to contract and retract when child bonds. Severe physical and pharmacological factors affect the contraction. Since morning, sir has rightly said that there are thrombotamponade, there is arterial tamponade, and there is myotamponade. If this is not working properly, there is development of PPH, and it is correlated with the fourth stage of labor. So what are the challenges we are finding? Manoj Bhai is rightly saying there is delay in diagnosis. Many cases of PPH without any risk factor. Patient is fine, normal delivery, even though she is getting PPH. Visual estimation, how many blood loss is there? 500, 200, we don't know. And under and over estimation of blood loss. That's why there are special specifications. We can collect them like uterine rafts, we can wait, and we can have an assessment of blood loss so we can know. This is statistics, sir, it is 1967. Before I go on, still it got true of shock index. It is heart rate divided by systolic blood pressure. And this will give the right idea that at which state this woman is. She needs urgent resuscitation if it is below or equivalent to 1.7. So those women who have lost more than 1,500 blood loss, it is 1967 statistics, and shock index is the right thing in the cases of PPH. You can say that how much blood loss is there. We have got so many drugs in our armament here. We have got oxytocin, misoprostol, prostaglandin, but FOCSI has endorsed in 2020, carbetocin is the new molecule which can save women's life. WHO is also enduring carbotation. Then about FIGO. FIGO also says in absence of oxytocin, or when you are not sure that this oxytocin is kept in refrigerator, you can use carbetocin as a second drug of management. So what is this carbetocin? Carbetocin is just analog of ortho-meta-para differentiation of oxytocin. It is the sibling of oxytocin, elder sister or younger sister of oxytocin. So it has got same effect of oxytocin. But what is the difference? If you see oxytocin, half-life is only 3 to 5 minutes. But when she see half-life of carbetocin, it is 33 minutes to 55 minutes. That is the sufficient time. Take nutraceutical contract, and it will give you full confidence that now your patient has got no bleeding per vagina. So what is carbetocin? It is a carba analog. Not Dr. Carba from because it is given the lamp. It is carba analog, that is orthometa and vera, with prolonged activity and half-life due to deamination with products of carbetocin with aminopeptase cleavage and replacement of the disulfide bond and CH2 protects analog from disulfide cleavage due to its glycosidy. Carbetocin is new long-acting synthetic analog of oxytocin with agonist property. It is available at RTS, that is room temperature stable. It is stable up to 40 degrees centigrade for 6 months. You can store it 30 degrees centigrade. Do not freeze. Keep the vial out in the garden. You have to protect that from light. It is stable at 30 degrees centigrade with 75% humidity for at least 6 months. Why carbetocin is not coming in market? Because sir is rightly said, Bakul Bhai said that carbetocin was there. Sir, it was there, but it was not heat stable. It is has to, we have to protect in cold chain. Then in 2018, they had added isotonic agent like mannitol that adjusted the pH with sodium sulfide. They had added antioxidant like L-methionine and they had buffer like succinic acid. And this all component make it is room stable, room temperature stable carbetocin. 2018 first trial was published with 350 patients which comparing population, intervention, competitor and outcome that versus 100 microgram of carbetocin versus 5 international unit of oxytocin, because oxytocin we are using since long. You can see the result in carbetocin, there is no PPH. You can see that more than 50 ml of blood loss was there comparing to carbetocin. So if you see carbetocin, there is no need of additional intratomic agent. Here in oxytocin group, we have to use 48 patients has to use another intratomic agent. So this is a single agent. If you combine the price of 5 oxytocin, 1 misoprostol, 2 carboprost, and 1 that is prostodine, it is equivocal to 1 ampoule of carbetocin. That is 480 to 500 rupees. 1 ml solution, you can have a very good neutrophonic control for 45 to 60 minutes. There is very less side effect compared to oxytocin between the oxytocin and carbetocin. So concluded that intravenous carbetocin is more effective than intravenous oxytocin for the prevention of atonic PPH among the singleton pregnancy with at least one risk factor of postpartum hemorrhage. What our Cochrane says? Cochrane has done lots of study with primary outcome of PPH and secondary outcome of all maternal death, need for additional uterotonic, need for transfusion, need for manual removal of placenta, need for volume of blood, duration of third stage of labor, changes of hemoglobin and admission to NICU, breastfeeding changes, and what they found with carbetocin, there is 41 fewer cases of blood loss with 1000 women birth compared to oxytocin. When it comes to 1000 ml of blood loss, 5 fewer cases. Who have got less than 500. This is very busy slide, but WHO in 2018 with Cochrane networks confirmed then it is superior in controlling TPA, there is no need of additional uterotonic agent, blood loss will be less, there is no change in hemoglobinopathy, and there is no difficulty in woman who is breastfeeding compared to all uterotonics in our armamentarium like misoprostol, injectable prostaglandin, ergometrin, methylergometrin with oxytocin, and misoprost with oxytocin. Then comes the champion trial. It is a carbetocin hemorrhagic prevention, a non-inferior study of comparing heat stable carbetocin with oxytocin. And this duratocin molecule was used in multicentric trial of carbetocin. And India, Bhuvaneshwar one was the participant, and Dr. Krishi Mahapatra, who is going to present carbetocin presentation in the morning, he is one of the participants of that champion trial. And is waiting since 2018 that this product should come in India, because this is only heat stable or room temperature stable carbetocin available in the world. And same molecule is marketed by the company who has sponsored me. It is intervention of 1000 milligram, 100 milligram of carbetocin and compared with 10 units of oxytocin. And outcome, comparison of the blood loss and use of additional uterotonin. What they found, there is non-inferiority. I love the word non-inferiority. Because in 2016, I published my paper on dihydrogestone. In 2019, paper of Griesinger has came. At that time, I know of the word of non-inferiority. When you are comparing anything with the absolute in the market, that is master in the market, that is micronized progesterone. Then we are comparing dihydrogestone with micronized progesterone. And in that trial, they have proven that it is non-inferior. It doesn't say it is superior. It is equivalent or non-inferior. So oxytocin was there in market since long. In our body, there is oxytocin. So it was non-inferior in delivering the blood of 5,500 or 1,000 ml. And ultimately, they have proven that it is a very good molecule. So with non-inferiority demonstrated compared to 10 units of oxytocin, other outcomes are the safety outcome between these two drugs. Then international consensus comes on the uterotonic, and that came in 2019. What they say? Oxytocin has got higher adverse effect compared with rapid high dilution of dose. Research was lacking of oxytocin. Sir is using 5 units, somebody is using 15 units, somebody is using 20 units. There is no consensus. How much oxytocin you have to give in postpartum period in cesarean cases in normal delivery? So we cannot have a perfect data that which dose of oxytocin will give you 100% uterotonic agent. So they had concluded that carbetocin is a longer acting analog of oxytocin, with similar mechanism of action, with least side effect, increased duration of action of carbetocin compared with oxytocin eliminates the require of infusion after the initial dose. So therefore, it becomes the preferred first-line drug rather than oxytocin. Then we have to think of our anesthetic friends, because sometimes if we give more oxytocin, anesthetic friends say don't give much oxytocin. So anesthetic community has also endorsed various guidelines that if you use in uterine atonic, carbetocin amongst the three most effective uterotonic available in market, carbetocin reduces addition of uterotonic with oxytocin in women come going for cesarean section. So what is carbetocin, which is room temperature stable? What is the indication? It is usually indicated in the prevention of postpartum hemorrhage due to uterine atonic. Dose you can use in cesarean section with spinal, or you can use in vaginal delivery. Withdrawal ml of solution, that is 1 ml of vial is available in market, 100 microgram. If you want to use in IV preparation, you can give directly also. But if you dilute in 10 ml of normal saline and give it slowly, you can use it intramuscularly also. And it should be used after delivery of baby and as soon as the placenta delivers. So you can use intravenously over 1 minute, you can use single dose, there is room temperature, there is no need for further doses, and the use of duratocin or RTS at the stage before delivery of the infant is not appropriate, so you have to use after the delivery. There is no data of additional uses of carbetocin after you use this, but there are word of caution, you cannot use in pregnancy, you cannot use it as an induction of labor. You have to be aware of renal and hepatic dysfunction. You cannot use in epilepsy and hypersensitivity to other products. Last few slides. I will stick to the time and we won't take more time. So carbetocin proves efficacy in cesarean section, significantly reduces blood loss. There is no need of additional uterotonic. Significantly reduces uterine massage. In morning, I says don't tap the uterus, just handle it very gently, just like your girlfriend. Recommended dose of intranasal concentration by 2019 by anesthesiologist. It is significantly reduces blood loss and is comparable profile with all cardiac patients. Significantly reducing 500 ml 1000 blood, significantly reduces additional ultratonic and comparable safety with cardiac patients. So by your venu, it is came to from Badan 8 to Badan 2, carbidopa. Now it is coming in the second number, and world will see after it will surpass the oxytocin and will become in the first number in the PPH Geetamala as a carbidopa new drug. So it is a room stable carbidopa, one step ahead of utrinetronic, delivers reliable efficacy, longer half-life of 140 minutes, proven safety and efficacy, requires no refrigeration, reduces needs of additional utrinetronic in the blood. So ultimately our goal, that everybody should be happy. Please play the sound, sir.
Hello. Sound.
You can play the sound. So ultimately our goal, that no mother should die, everybody should be happy, everybody should go here with little bit knowledge of PPH sound. Enclave, and we have to save one or another.
Thank you.
Previous slide. Yes.
That is the line to be happy is now, and the place to be happy is here, and the way to be happy is to make someone happy, and then the truth of heaven right here.
So this is a poem of nursery grade.
The time to be happy is now, and the place to be happy is here, and the way to be happy is to make someone happy, and have a little heaven right here.
So thank you very much. At this outset, I would like to, everybody should vote for Dr. Sunita. She is our BookC candidate for presidential election 2023. Thank you very much PPH Enclave for giving me opportunity. Thank you Mahesh Bhai for giving this opportunity to share my words on carbidopa. Thank you.